number one corn shell because I'm gluten free, less cheese, a little more lettuce just for the greens, and a bottle of water if that's fine.
And I want a number three.
Okay, can I get a number three as
with
well,
no
please?
Ketchup.
No ketchup.
I'm sorry, with ketchup and mustard only.
Ketchup and mustard only.
Make sure, and then a medium Dr. Pepper.
And then a medium
can
Dr.
You
Pepper.
Ask them if they can add vanilla.
And do you, excuse, can you add vanilla?
Can you add vanilla? I don't think they can. You know what? Whatever. That's fine.
Okay.
That's
okay,
good.
Great. Thank you.
Oh, oh, and an apple pie.
Oh, I'm sorry. Can I get an apple pie? Hi.
Welcome to Superfruit, the best show on the internet. Hi. My name is Brad Pitt.
My name is Angelina Jolie.
And together,
we adopt
millions of children. So today, we're going to do a Q&A. So we went to Twitter. Follow us on Twitter.
Wow, yeah.
And we tweeted this. And you tweeted back some amazing questions, and so we're gonna answer every question that you've ever had. So Michaela asked, what is your favorite alcoholic beverage? This is important.
Oh god.
You're right, it is important.
So many options.
There are so many options. If you ever go to Cheesecake Factory, get the strawberry martini, it will change your life.
Those are I really enjoy a good glass of Chardonnay. Doesn't have to be nice, it just has to do the job. And if it does the job and tastes somewhat decent, then sign me up. So Bren1D asks, if there was a book on your whole entire life, would you read it till the end?
No.
I don't think I would want to, but I think I would.
I think I would be tempted a little bit.
Like one day I would just be like a little tipsy and feeling brave and I would just read to the end on impulse. And it'd be like, you die by a rabid squirrels attacking your face, and then I'd be like, no, I don't
right.
want to know. It ruins the surprise.
But then you're gonna spend your whole life avoiding that.
I know. So. You see a squirrel, you're gonna like run away.
And that's not a fun way to live.
I know.
Release your inhibitions, feel the rain on your skin. No one else can do it for you. Only you can live.
Oh, is that our Gregorian chant version? Maddie says, where the frick do you get your clothes?
Oh, well,
we can tell you.
Places.
Let's name off the places. Joyridge. Wild Style.
Essence.com is where I get all my clothes.
Urban Outfitters.
Urban Outfitters, American Apparel.
That's about it.
Sarah Grace asks, Idina Menzel or Kristen Chenoweth?
Kristen Chenoweth.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah.
I love Idina.
I think she's amazing.
But Kristen is so funny and so talented.
That's true. They're both really amazing. That's a really hard choice.
That is a really hard choice.
Oh my god, Idina looks so good at the Oscars though.
Oh my god. Lauren says, has a fan ever made you fear for your safety? Love you.
Yeah, actually, one guy made us like little treats, but he was like really quiet and creepy and was like, I promise I didn't poison them. And we were like, okay.
Maybe we should meet up.
But then we still ate all of them.
We still ate all of them, because you know us. I have had a couple instances where I've been a little freaked out. Someone tweeted me a picture of my parents' house and said, hurt your home.
Okay, yeah, that's weird, and that is not okay.
And then someone else made a Tumblr post that was like, we followed Scott all around Arlington and finally pretended we ran into him at CVS. And stuff
what?
Like that, that kind of makes me uncomfortable.
Millimeter asks, any hidden talents?
I have a hidden talent.
What is
it? I can solve a Rubik's Cube.
That's impressive.
Thank you.
I actually cannot do that.
Yeah, no. I was like the most nerdy in high school and I would just bring it to school and I would show off to all my friends. I think like 23 was my best time, not to brag.
I can make origami paper cranes.
That's cool. That's cute.
Thank you.
I know, I always like when you make those.
Thank you.
You know, you never made one of those for me.
I'll make you one. I used to make them all the time because there was this book when I was in elementary school. It was a bad story. But it was like this guy who made, there was this kid who made like 1,000 or something. I don't know what the end result of that story was, but I wanted to make 1,000.
I'm inspired.
Are you serious? I'm so over you right now.
Brianna says, what law would get passed if you had the political influence? Probably that gay marriage is banned from all states.
I would have to agree.
Because honestly, it's like not natural.
And I'm not a big supporter, like all for like free love and everything, but like
but
when
like,
you shove it down my throat.
Like, yeah, you can be gay, but don't marry people.
Thank you.
Two people that love each other getting married.
What? Heresy.
It's you're acting like this is a free country. Anyways.
But we won't keep you.
By the way, that was sarcasm for all of y'all that are about to freak out.
Yeah. Lemon Guarded asks, what celebrity would you trade lives with? Beyonce.
Beyonce.
she never makes a mistake, and that would be a cool life to live, because yeah. I make a lot of them.
And if you look at her Tumblr, you're literally just like, how is your life so cool? She's always like on a beach or in a private jet or performing for millions or being perfect or performing in the opening of the Grammys. It's like, what? And I've listened to her album so much I could die.
But I still love it. I still enjoy it.
Me too. Really. We still are like, what are we listening to today?
I guess Drunk in Love by Beyonce.
Dev asks, what do you do when you have too much energy?
It's Anthony Halla asks, do you guys use text language in real life? Absolutely.
LOL, no. We won't keep you.
But yeah, I actually do. I say LOL sometimes. Actually, I think that's the only thing I ever say.
You do say it, but you don't mean it like you mean it when you do it in the text.
You're right.
Or do you?
I feel like it's whenever I'm uncomfortable, I'm always like, LOL. Or somebody tells a really bad joke.
Oh my god, you always do that to me. That's how I know it's bad. You should be like, LOL. Or you'll be like, stop.
That's not true.
Harper says, describe how a dinner with Beyonce, Miley Cyrus, Harry Styles, and Kanye West would be like. That's a lot of people. Beyonce would be really fun and awkward because I'd be stressed out and passed out. Miley Cyrus, I feel like it would be messy. Harry Styles, Mitch would just be making out with him the whole time, so it'd be like, I'd feel like that awkward
third wheel, but, you know.
And Kanye West,
I would rather die than go to dinner with Kanye West, to be honest. That sounds bad.
He would just talk about himself the whole time, and we like to talk about ourselves, so
so where is the line with you?
Sorry, we won't keep going.
Jay Baratarin asks, do you sleep in pajamas, underwear, or naked?
Naked. together. Graham says, why does Mitch Grassi look like Natalie Portman with a beard?
I see it a little bit.
I see it a little bit too. Yeah. She's got snatched eyebrows.
I'm dying in her chest hair. Michelle Luongo asks, what are your nationalities? I am half Italian, and I'm also half Irish, Scottish, and Welsh, so I'm a
I'm like 90% German and 10% English, I think. I might have made that up for some reason. Wow.
I'm just kidding. You're 10% English?
Yeah.
What does that mean? Like from
like
England?
English, like England.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I didn't ask for the two.
No, it's time for weekly obsession.
Great.
My weekly obsession is all of us in Pentatonix got new in-ears.
We did.
And of course, being the queens that Kirsty, Mitch, and I are, we got Swarovski in-ears, but in different colors. Yep. They sparkle on stage.
Yes,
like
they
the
do.
Stars in the sky.
It's not wrong.
But we won't keep you. What's your weekly obsession?
My weekly obsession is actually something really weird. I have just become, ever since we went to IHOP that one time,
it's every day.
I used Tabasco sauce on my eggs, and I loved it. So I went to the grocery store and bought Tabasco sauce, and that's my obsession. I've literally been putting it on everything.
Get it. Acid reflux.
Yeah, but...
Yeah, I want to hear the good song. My song of the week, you're not gonna believe this, everyone.
I'm nervous.
It was my least favorite song on the Beyonce album, but I've been listening to it a lot this week because it's kind of growing on me, and it's No Angel by Beyonce.
I feel that.
Before you start hating, go listen to it a few times. The production's sick. Wear some good headphones. And it kind of goes hard. I know. We've been living. Should we do a cover of it?
Yeah, do you want to?
Oh my god.
I'm down. So my song of the week is called And by Arca. And if you don't know who Arca is, he produced on Yeezus. And he's Venezuelan, I believe. And he's really young, but he's killing it. And he makes the weirdest music, but I'm super into it. It's really bassy and hip-hoppy and glitchy and... And yeah, I've just had it on repeat.
That's all we have time for. That's been on Super Bowl. We love you so much.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. I didn't know that was confusing. I do.
Yeah, it's really small.
Really?
Yeah.
No one will notice. Oh my god, I hope not. If I've had something in my teeth the whole time, I'm gonna kill myself. I'm such a fat.
I know.
Is it gone? Oh my god, I'm ugly. I wish I didn't eat so much. This wouldn't happen.
I just noticed it. I wanted to be a good friend to you.
I know. I hate when friends like don't tell you.
I didn't want to tell you. I didn't want to tell you.
I have a big ketchup mark on your face.
Are you serious? We don't have time for this.
Okay, it's gone.